Hey you, and welcome. I'm Mr. Barry. In this whole video, I want to talk about being able to read SD cards with your Chromebook. Now, normally, I would get an SD card put into my Chromebook and it works without any issues. However, one of my subscribers, name of Steve, he's been having an issue. And he works at a place where it's very important that he's able to read his SD cards. So he would put in the SD card and wouldn't read it, wouldn't recognize it at all. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take you through the steps of actually turning on or enabling full access so that any of your apps will be able to see and use your SD card. And before we get started, I would like to reminding everyone to please click on that thumbs up, share the video, comment down below, because I do read your comments. And if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to my channel. Also, some have noticed that I have dogs in the back. So here we go. Ushi. This is Chad right here. Here you go, Chad. Ushi. Where's Ushi? I bet she's hiding. I want to see if she's hiding. Hey, Ushi. Ushi. Come on, Ushi. Here you go, Ushi. Ushi. Ah, there's Ushi. So let's give Ushi a snack here for being brave enough to show herself on the camera. Here you go, Ushi. And this is Chad over here. Now I have another one too, but the other one there is in the other room right now. So these are wonderful pet dogs that I have there. This is Ushi, and then this is Chad. And they are adorable. They are adorable. Alrighty, so let's get into the Chromebook and show you exactly how to enable SD card support right there. Hey, here we are in my Chromebook. Now what I'd like you to do is take your mouse and down in the lower corner where you see that time, go ahead and click in that lower corner, and you notice that it should pop up and you see more options. Notice that one of those options looks like a gear icon. If you take your mouse and float over there, it will say settings. So go ahead and click on settings now. And that will open up our settings window. Now, below the settings, we notice that it says the word device. We're going to be affecting something in the device there, so click on device. And now we see device options like touchpad, keyboard, and on we go. If you notice one of these, it says storage management, so click on that. And right away, we see our internal storage. What's in use? Well, we got about 60 gigs in use and about 68 gigs available. My files are taking about 20 gigs. You got browsing data about a half a gig, apps taking up about 12 gigs, and other users about another gig. The system is taking about 27 gigs, right? Now at the bottom, you'll notice it says external storage preferences. That's the one that we need to get into the SD cards management there. So let's click on there. And here it says apps from Google Play may require the full file system access to read and write files on external storage devices. Files and folders created on the device are visible to anyone who uses the external drive. So if you've saved files onto your SD card or your external device there, you take it out and you plug it into another machine, they should be visible. All right. Available devices, SD card, there it is. This you want to make sure that that's off, all right, that prevents using it. And click it again, and now it'll have a little bluish background, and now it's enabled and on. It's that easy. So there you go, now you've enabled your SD card so that you would be able to save files to it, read files from it, and all that. Now, normally that's already turned on by default, but in the case of Steve, I believe that one may have been turned off. All right, so let's close this off and we're going to exit our settings. I'm going to show you now actually using the SD card. So I'm going to flip to the other side and I'm going to click on the app launcher. And right there it says search for your tabs and files and apps. So I'm going to type in the word files and it comes up to that very first one. First one that we see there is the files app. And it's a blue circle with a bluish or light blue folder in it. Boom. You notice on my shelf at the bottom, I have it there, so you can actually pin it to the shelf, which is what I do, because I'm always using it. But if not, hey, you can always find it this other way. So let's go ahead and just double click this and open up and see what we have. And let me flip to the other side now. Okay, so here we're inside of the Files app. This is like the Windows Explorer of Microsoft Windows. And if you notice there, we have Recent, and then we have My Files, Downloads. So Downloads is great. If you download any files, any work, any like documents, boom, they will be found there. And someone was asking me the other day, says, can I use my Chromebook to work with Microsoft Office documents, PowerPoint, spreadsheets, and other things like that? And I said, yes, it'll work with your Excel spreadsheets, it'll work with Word documents, as well as PowerPoint presentations. So it does all of those things for us, and those would be downloaded into the Downloads folder. Now, I do have another a separate video on actually working with Microsoft Word documents with Microsoft Word on a Chromebook. In that video, I'll have that up there as a link. So later you can actually click on there and see that other video on where this app, this Microsoft Office app is. If you don't want to do that, we do also have Google Docs, Google Sheets, and Google Slides right there built into your Chromebook. Those will open, edit, and save Microsoft Word documents as a Microsoft Word document. So you'd be able to share it with your friends and they would see it exactly the way you see it on your screen. And there's actually more tools now in Google Docs than Microsoft Word ever had. So that's something to think about. Next, we have Play Files, and then we have the Google Drive, and then we have the SD card. So there it is. When we enabled the view there, it should appear there. And you can double click there and then copy and paste files there or work with them, whatever you need to do there. So we've done that. Now let's just say that your machine is having a really difficult time in doing anything. It's not like allowing you to log in. It's not allowing you to do work. Like let's say that you were connected to a printer and suddenly it doesn't see the printer. You go, I've been working with this every day and today it doesn't see the printer. Well, I actually have videos on, you know, setting up your Chromebook with your printer, but let's just say that had already been done. And you go, well, why is it not recognizing my printer today? The number one reason would be if either your Chromebook or the printer is now on a different SSID. That is a network name. Most routers have multiple SSIDs, 3 to 4 or even more. And what happens is sometimes we open up the Chromebook and for some reason it'll go to a different SSID. I've seen that. It's rare, but it happens. When that happens, if you have your printer on SSID number 1 and your printer goes to number 2, guess what? You're not printing that day. So you want to make sure that both devices, your printer and your Chromebook, are on the same SSID. But let's say that you're having other issues, like you're not being able to log in, or your computer is just giving you general headaches. Do a power wash. And you say, Mr. Barry, I don't want to do a power wash. It seems rather, a severe thing. The reality is it only takes seconds and then you're back up and running in seconds. It's actually that quick. You simply go to your settings, type in power wash, and boom. It will then do a power wash. I do have a separate video on that though, in case you're a little bit worried about it, and that one will be above me there. So that will be a link to the power wash video. Again, that only takes seconds to do. And then you log into your machine after it does the power wash. It'll reset all your settings and your apps and all that. You don't lose your data, which is nice. So your data that's in your Google Drive or on your external devices, it's still there. And that's why I do it quite often. If my machine is even slow, if it's a little bit sluggish, I will do a power wash and then simply re-log in and all my stuff it will be there on my SD card. Hey, that was easy, huh? Just basically getting into your settings and finding the storage management settings there. And I would like to remind everyone, please, you know, subscribe and If you have a question or if you have an idea for a future video, please leave that down in the comments there below the video. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to share something with you and also some music that has been shared with me that's really been helping me. Just to let you know, I have autism, and so living out in the world is very, very stressful. Yes, I've been a teacher for over 20 years and everything, and every day there has been extremely stressful, making the videos stressful. But but due to your tremendous support out there, it has really helped me quite a bit there. And what we're going to do is I'm going to share you a song that's been shared with me that really helps me really focus and kind of opens up my mind to think, because that's one of my problems there is a lot of times if I'm out about, it's hard for me to think and to understand what's going on around me. So that song there, I'll have the name of it and who donated or who created that song. I have those two things there up there in text form for you. Alrighty, appreciate every one of you there, and thank you very much. Bye-bye.